One of the major issues that the society is facing right now is probably water. But here in London, it's raining right now. But so why do I say that water is a problem in this society?
Why does inflation happen? Who influences...
Hey, it's Dario and this is Divity Finance, a platform where we can share our best tips and tools when it comes to trading, investing, or finance in general. And if you love the subject, please consider subscribing. So as I was saying, water is getting more and more an issue in this economy and in this society. But why is that? Well, it's mainly because the majority of water we have in the planet is salty and is difficult to extract and to make in drinking water. So one of the issues that we are facing right now is turning water that we cannot drink in water that we can drink, because the drinking water is getting more and more rare. Of course, countries such as the UK, Switzerland, Italy, and those countries don't have a major problem in this. But what about Australia? What about Africa? What about the South America? Many of those countries are poor in drinking water, easy to extract, so they may need to rely on salty water. But to make salty water drinkable, they need to purify it, and they need some companies that will purify the water and transform it in drinking water. So, what does this mean for the business of a society that is involved in this kind of activities? That means more money. And how do we make money out of other companies that make money? We invest in them. As you may know by now, my secret love when it comes to investing are ETFs. That's because they are really simple to understand, they are really simple to find, and they give you a diversification even if you have a small amount of money, a small capital to start investing. That is why I spent a little bit of my hours to look for good ETFs, actually two ETFs, that you can buy in order to invest in water. So what we need to do is to invest in companies that are involved in these activities. So in the purification, in the supply, in the extraction of water. And to do that, we want to diversify. And to do that, we need to invest in ETFs. But hey, before we start, if you enjoyed the video, please leave it a like and let me know in the comments down below if you plan on investing on water. So as you may know, ETFs follow indices. So before choosing the ETF, you should choose the index. But we are going to talk about how to choose ETFs in later videos. But what I did here is choosing an index first. And the index I chose is the S&P Global Water. Of course, I want to go global, I don't want to go in a specific country, because I want to diversify as much as possible. And the S&P Global Water gives me the chance to do exactly that, because it's an index that follows the 50 biggest companies involved in the water business. So the ETFs, as I mentioned, are two. That's because one is for Europeans and one is for Americans. I don't know if Americans can buy ETFs from Europe. I think they can, but I know that Europeans cannot buy all ETFs in America. That's why I chose two ETFs. The first one is the iShare Global Water, which again follows the S&P Global Water. This ETF has a total expense ratio of 0.65%, which is not that much if we think that it's a sector index, okay? It's not just a global index. So 0.65%, it's not a bad expense. And also, it's a physical replication, and that's always nice, you know, I generally prefer physical replication than synthetic replication, even though we know that the risks are really small in synthetic, but we are going to talk about that in a later video when we talk about how to choose ETFs. Also, I want to mention that this ETF has an average volatility per year of 12.5%, which is not a lot actually, okay? A global ETF, a general MSCI World ETF, has a more or less that volatility. So it's not an industry that is particularly risky, at least not more than other industries. The second ETF, which is more for Americans, is the Invesco S&P Global Water, which has a total expense ratio of 0.62%, which again, it's not a lot actually. It has a similar volatility as the iShare, which is 13% a year on average, and as the iShare, which I didn't mention maybe, has dividends. I don't generally like ETFs that give dividends, that because I want the dividends reinvested and I don't want to pay taxes on those dividends. But nonetheless, these are the two ETFs, the best ETFs that I could find, and so we will need to take the dividend anyways. So this is all I had to say for water. My advice here is to keep an eye on the industry of water, because again, the demand of water is raising every day and we may take good profits from this increase in demand. So yeah, this is all I had to say for water and ETFs on water. But hey, let me know if you have found other ETFs that are better or stocks that might perform particularly good in the next years. But so, if you enjoyed the video, please leave it a like and let me know in the comments down below if you plan on investing on water. And I'll see you in the next video. Yes, I'm just 20 years old, and yes, I did all the paperwork to buy an apartment on behalf of my parents. And when I mean all, I mean all. My parents just had to sell the apartment and sign some papers. And finally, yes, I also rented out the apartment by choosing the